Hey guys, I'm Jake Boomer with Lemonade Marine and Lithium Pros, and today I want to do kind of an off-the-wall battery configuration video that I feel like is kind of solving some of the newer problems we're dealing with all of this high-end, high-technology imaging that we have on our boats, the forward-facing imaging, the 360, all that stuff. Everybody's running 5 graphs now with all kinds of accessories, and even the boat that we built on Rig My Ride, if you check it up on our YouTube page, my 2019, that was state of the art in 2019. Now we're running into issues with all this technology, running into battery issues. And so we've designed a couple systems look kind of like this. We'll show you this. Before we go out to the shop though, I just kind of want to lay this video out. We tried to start shooting this video in the beginning of this last year, 22, but I hadn't tested a lot of the scenarios. And so I didn't want to put it out there yet, but what had driven me into needing to change, needing to add more battery power and separate power from like my starting battery and things like that was, I had been in a tournament and my batteries prevented me from fishing the last half an hour. It made me pull up shop and run into weigh-in because I didn't think my motor was gonna start, and it cost me $9,000. I was one spot out of the check. I was in an area where I was catching really well, and I ended up pulling up and heading back in because I didn't want to lose my points that would have qualified me for the championship. Even though I was catching them, I'd finally found them after 3 days of struggling. I'd finally gotten into a group of them and culled up from 57th to 34th. Well, they paid down to 33rd. The reason I bailed out on that spot was I went to go to the other side of the bay where I had started. So I went to crank the motor up and it did that whoa, it wasn't gonna start, and I panicked. I felt like if it didn't start and I didn't get to weigh in, I would lose my chances at the championship, which was, you know, $500,000, $250,000 championship. So I pulled up shop, but I had actually found a weigh release site. And so I was crushing them. For the last hour, for the first time in this Grand Lake tournament, I was actually catching bass. I feel like the 8 or 6 ounces I needed to move up and cash a check was gonna be pretty easy. I only needed to cull like a 197, and I just caught like 7 in a row. So anyways, that scenario really prompted this video because I feel like a lot of people are stuck in a weird scenario where they already bought some lithium batteries, or they have lithium batteries and they don't like the hell they have to charge them, or they have a Yamaha like I have where you need a graph battery. You can't use lithium as your cranking battery because Yamaha will deny warranty. Mercury has come out and said that they won't deny warranty if you use a lithium battery, but they're still having issues with them. And so we've got some good layouts here and give you guys some ideas on maybe the best way to set your boat up so that you fish all day long, your graphs don't die when you fire up your motor, and you never ever worry about your motor starting when it's time to run to check-in. So check it out. All right, so this is the inside of my 921 Pro XP. As I ran it through 22 after I made the battery change. The biggest change that you'll see from the first setup is this battery is new. The first setup, I didn't have this battery. I had this large Northstar AGM cranker, and it was connected to this massive 80 amp hour 36 volt trolling motor bank through the PowerPole charge. And so ideally in that scenario, if this battery got low, the PowerPole charge should move energy from this large trolling motor bank to this battery. What I found though is with 2 Solexes at the console, a 15 inch Solex at the bow, along with 360, a 12 inch Garmin and LiveScope, this battery, no matter how much was pulled out of the PowerPole charge from these trolling motor batteries, could keep this battery alive all day long. And that's what created the scenario where I had a poor start that end of that tournament and ended up having to leave early and costing myself a good check. So the problem or the solution was this extra battery. Well, because I have a Yamaha, I couldn't run 2 lithiums. And a lot of people in the scenario I'm in, or any of these scenarios, doesn't want to buy 2 lithiums anyway. But you'll see a lot of guys will buy 2 lithiums and put them in parallel and run their graphs and their big motor off of it. I actually found that I think I like this scenario way better. And let me explain it a little bit. The biggest thing I did was I added this 129 amp hour 12 volt graph battery and then ran direct power to the graphs. My graphs are separate from the motor circuit. So when I start the motor, my graphs never die. They never feel that voltage drop. They're not anywhere near that circuit. They are independent on this direct power scenario. Instead of hooking my PowerPole charge to the starting motor, I actually hooked it to this graph battery. So now my graph battery and my trolling motor batteries are sharing energy between each other through the PowerPole charge.
What I like about that is the charge still will take care of charging my 36 volt batteries at night, along with this massive 12 volt battery bank. That leaves this battery independent of the system. It does not, it's not connected to any of these two, this other two banks, and it is not charged through the PowerPole charge. Well, you say, well, that stinks. So what, are you gonna put another charger in to charge this battery? Well, I haven't had to, because this battery only runs the power poles, the live well pumps, and the lights, and that's it. Accessories is all it runs, and it's charged every time I run the motor. And since it's never pulled down great amounts, like two 12-inch Solexes would really pull this down, since it's not connected to graphs, it never gets low in voltage, I very rarely have to charge it. Just to be careful, though, during tournament days, like if I run my live well pumps all day long, I just use this. I plug this in when I plug my boat in, and I charge it manually. It generally only charges for about an hour. It's never very low. I've never had an issue. I've always made it back to weigh in, and all day long. I can fish daylight till dark in the middle of July when it's 100 degrees outside. When I go to crank my motor at 8:30 at night, it still sounds like it's a brand new battery. The second in the scenario I think is the coolest with this setup is that with these batteries working together, there's two scenarios you see on the water. And these two, then this setup will actually help you with each one of those scenarios. And the way that works is, generally, if you're on your graphs all day long, let's just say you're offshore and you got your graphs banging away at, you know, mega frequencies, and you're just in trolling motor spot lock because you're using your graphs to do more so your fishing, or you're looking for offshore structure with side imaging, this graph is gonna get most of the usage, right? If this graph gets low, these batteries aren't doing much, because most of the time your trolling motor isn't on 100 if you're using your graph a lot. If you're, especially if you're forward imaging, your trolling motor is used very little. So what ends up happening, or what happened to me last year, was on those days when you're offshore, like at Pickwick Lake or your Watts Bar and your fishing brush piles, your trolling motor batteries are hardly getting used at all. So the PowerPole charge would keep this battery, as it was running all your graphs, charged from these batteries. It would move this energy into this side, which was amazing because my graphs were always at 12.8 volts. I always had great, clarity in the forward imaging and in the 360. I just never had any issues with it. The second scenario you'll run into in bass fishing that we saw in the last couple of years is you'll be up shallow, like you're bed fishing, and you're chasing them around and your trolling motor's on 100 all day long. Generally on those days, the day when you're trolling motor heavy, you're not gonna be using your graphs very much. And I can give you another example. Like, we fish the Columbia River up and in the current, and it's shallow, and your trolling motor's on 100 the whole time. You generally don't need your graphs for that scenario. You can see the bottom. In that scenario, now you have a whole extra 129 amp hour battery that the PowerPole charge will pull from and put into your trolling motor batteries, because you're not using your graphs that much anyway. And so what I found was, in either one of those two scenarios, the PowerPole charge kind of aligned these two massive battery banks, and I never had battery issues. And it solved all of my problems. It was the best scenario I've ran in the last couple of years, as far as never worrying about a jump start, never running out of power, never worrying about having to shut graphs down towards the end of the day because you're worried about it starting when it's time to run back. I got so confident in this system that when I turned my live wells on in the morning, I just put them on manual and ran them all day. I never ran a live well timer. So there's a lot of options here, and this is probably about the best way I've gone about this scenario, or getting to this scenario, because almost everybody we deal with has something like a PowerPole charge or a 36 volt charger or an inline charger. And what they end up with is this scenario where they don't know how to not spend $4,000 to get more graph power, which is, it's gonna be super important with all these new graphs that everybody's gonna be running. And so they're forced to make big changes. This was, I literally added one battery, changed the configuration of my PowerPole charge, and I feel like I had kind of the best scenario for either type of fishing I had to do, hard on the trolling motor or hard on the graphs. This bank was more than good enough. So anyways, if you guys like that setup, if you guys got more questions, call Limit Out Marine, give us a shout. Thanks for watching, guys.